This is Democracy Now! When we come back, they're calling it the biggest environmental battle in New York State history. We'll host a discussion about gas drilling. Stay with us. Miles Davis, Blue and Green, here on Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Sharif Abdul-Quddus. For our last segment, we turn to what some are calling the biggest environmental battle in New York State history. Last week, government regulators opened the door to natural gas drilling inside the Marcellus Shale watershed, which supplies drinking water to some 15 million people, including 9 million New Yorkers. Stretching from New York to Kentucky, the shale is believed to hold some of the world's largest deposits of natural gas. Proponents say that drilling will boost the nation's economic recovery and reduce dependence on foreign oil. But environmentalists are warning the drilling could contaminate New York's water supply, as it has in other states. The proposed regulations are now open for public comment until the end of the next month, followed by a final decision early next year. For more, we're joined by three guests. Here in our Firehouse studios, Joe Levine. He's co-founder of the group Damascus Citizens for Sustainability and NYH2O, which oppose the gas drilling. Albert Appleton is a former commissioner of the New York City Department of Environmental Protection and former director of the New York City Water and Sewer System. He currently teaches courses in sustainability and economics at Hunter College and Cooper Union and works as an international consultant on water issues. And joining us on the telephone is Brad Gill. He's executive director of the Independent Oil and Gas Association of New York, an oil industry group that supports drilling in the Marcellus Shale. We welcome you all to Democracy Now! Al, let's start with you. The significance of this decision of government regulators to open up the Marcellus Shale.
Well, it's not a decision to open up the Marcellus Shale as such. It's a decision to say, it's a claim, because it's actually not a decision yet, the comment period is going. It's a claim that the Marcellus Shale drilling as it's currently conducted can be done with adequate safeguards for the environment and the upstate rural economy. This is a claim that appears to be wrong, both on facts and interpretation.
Well, explain first, what is the Marcellus Shale and what's at stake here?
Well, the Marcellus Shale is about a 6,000 to 9,000 foot deep of layer of 600 million year old shale that has trapped in it an enormous amount of natural gas. They've always known this. But until they developed horizontal drilling and essentially drilling by fracturing, they weren't able to get the drilling out. The problem that what is at stake here is, well, that the natural gas that is derived in environmentally benign ways is a terrific fuel. Natural gas in shale fracking to obtain natural gas is such a, has so many environmental impacts that the cost to the environment and the cost to the rural economy outweigh the benefits of the natural gas as we are currently doing it. So the real question at stake from an economic point of view is, are we going to subsidize through externalizing environmental costs the fracking of natural gas formations, or are we going to try and develop a more sustainable natural gas policy?
And explain exactly, how does New York's water system currently work?
New York City's water system currently works by, it's a surface water system that collects rainfall and runoff from an area about the size of the state of Delaware. Unlike most other systems in the world, this water is so pure that we don't have to filter it. We merely have to treat it with chlorine and do some other statements. And this saves the city of New York billions and billions of dollars and gives it the quality for which it is famous worldwide. So, and the Marcellus and natural gas drilling in the New York City watershed would completely transform that. The bill for New York City would be billions of dollars annually.
We're also joined on the telephone by Brad Gill. He's the executive director of the Independent Oil and Gas Association of New York. Can you respond to some of what Al is talking about?
Sure, I'd be glad to. One thing I'd like to point out, and Al might argue this point, but drilling is not new to New York State, and when references are cited from other states where problems have occurred, I just want to point out that there are very significant differences between the regulations under which we operate in New York as opposed to some other states. And not only have we historically operated under very stringent guidelines, and in fact the most stringent in the nation, but we now are going to be operating under a new set of guidelines that will specifically be tailored to Marcellus development, exploration, and drilling. And those just were released last week, of course, about an 800-plus page document that's very comprehensive, very, very a tough set of regulations. Industry is going to have to comply with these. And at first blush, in looking at these regs, there's some significant controls and measures in here that will be in the, I'm sure, the permit requirements for drilling that will safeguard the water supplies. And the other thing is, I'd just like to point out that we have drilled in wetlands and aquifers and watersheds for years in New York State, and fracked wells for years in New York State, for decades. And so while some people say, yeah, but those are vertical wells, they're not horizontal Marcellus wells, the individual processes remain the same, and really nothing about a horizontal borehole that's deeper makes it any more of a threat than what we've been doing safely for years.
Joel Levine, you're co-founder of the group's Damascus Citizens for Sustainability. Respond to some of what Brad Gill was talking about.
I did have a little bit of difficulty hearing what he was saying.
However,
a couple of things really jump out at me. You know, this issue that they're going to treat New York special, and they're very comfortable with that as well. I don't know what that says about the industry at all that's been running roughshod over the rest of the country and doing a lot of damage to a lot of areas. It used to be said that it only happens out west, and it's different here in the states, in New York State. However, they've been operating in Pennsylvania, and there are incident after incident. And in fact, when he says that they've been operating successfully in watersheds and sensitive water areas, is also, you know, suspicious given that a freedom of information request by Environmental Working Group proved that there were no records kept about accidents that happened on drill sites. So at least that's what I heard Mr. Gill say, and that's what I could respond to, but it's, you know, ludicrous that now New York is going to do it better. One is to understand that this technology is intrinsically contaminating. The injection of toxic chemicals, and by the way, I heard Brad Gill speak months ago, and it wasn't so long ago that he said that there were no chemicals used in this process. It was only sand and water and soap. And this has been proven to not be the case. And in fact, there have been over 350 toxic chemicals that are injected with millions of gallons of water, taking that water out of the water supply, injecting it into the ground, contaminating aquifers. The air pollution is a whole different subject we could talk about.